Good evening. We have Sean Jackson. He's joining us from the Broadview Football Club. He's the coach of Broadview in Division 2. Welcome, Sean. How are you?
I'm good, thanks, Luke. How are you?
Good. You're going to do our weekly roundup just on last week's games. Brighton Bombers 23-19, 157 defeated. Gazer 6-4, 40, 117 margin.
Yeah, it's a big win, wasn't it? I was actually at that game. Yeah, Brighton, very, very experienced side. They've come into our competition second year now, and their side, the recruiting this year, has been really good, and a very, very comprehensive victory to Brighton on the weekend.
Gazer in deep trouble of being relegated, I would have thought, if two go down and Salisbury North aren't, who knows?
Yeah, it'll depend on what happens with Salisbury North, won't it? I guess there's a lot of water to go under that bridge yet, so can't tell you.
Yeah, struggling. A former powerhouse, really, in Division 1, Gazer, and just struggling a bit.
Yeah.
St. Peter's continued along their merry way. 11 goals, 672, defeated Unley Mercedes Jets. 7-5, 47. How do you see that?
Yeah, well, St. Peter's are obviously getting the job done week in, week out, aren't they? There haven't been too many games where they've actually smashed sides. I don't think we'll have too many big wins like Brighton recorded last week, but in saying that, they're getting the chocolates each week, and they've got a really good tool side. Luke Trenaud's
now
winning the side, two McLay boys plus Mitchell in the front half. They're Toby Schulz and Roberts are back now on the half back line, so you know they've got an extremely tall side. They're going to be tough to beat in the air. In saying that, four goals wasn't a massive margin on the weekend, so it wasn't too bad an effort from Unley.
Yeah, Unley, you just think maybe in September on the dry grounds with that tall side, it might be very hard to beat.
Yeah, look, I was pretty impressed with Unley. We played them a couple of weeks ago, and I think they're coming together quite nicely as well. So I don't think they'd be too disappointed with a four-goal loss against St. Peter's, given that St. Peter's haven't lost to anyone yet.
Yeah, they had played a lot of players. I know we did a broadcast there at about round two or three. It was actually against St. Peter's. And they played 37 players at that point of the season.
St. Peter's had or Unley?
Unley had.
Right, okay.
So they've a lot of injuries, and it's just starting to settle down now for them.
Yeah, they've had some good inclusions this year, some real experience around the ball in Munn and just escapes me from West Adelaide, 200 games of league footy at Western.
So
Daniel Kerr, yeah. So they've got some real good experience, solid bodies around the ball now.
Yeah, maybe the upset from last week was Golden Grove recorded their first win. It was 19-9, 123. Defeated Sacred Heart 14-8, 92. So a 31-point lead win to Golden Grove out of Harpers Field.
Yeah, I think if you looked at the results from the previous week, you would say it's an upset, given that Sacred Heart beat Foss Gammon and Golden Grove haven't won a game. But I was pretty sure that Golden Grove would get on a roll at some stage in the second half of the year. I remember speaking to Eric after we played him. He was a bit disappointed, but I said to him, if he can keep his best group on the park, they're capable of beating anyone the second half of the ladder. And so it was no great surprise to me. A good win, and I think they play Old Ignatians this week, Golden Grove, so they may well pull two in a row.
The next game was Foss Kingdom with over 16-15, 111. Defeated Old Iggy 7-5, 47, and that was at Karen Rolton over there in the city.
Yeah, Old Iggy's ground, which is a fantastic place to play footy.
Magnificent.
You'd expect some bounce back from Foss Kingdom from the previous week, given they lost to Sacred Heart. So no real surprise to me there. Foss Cameron are obviously a very good side, and we're probably too strong for Old Iggy's.
Yeah. It's weird. It's named Karen Rolton Oval, but you keep seeing Hunter Park. I don't know what it's called.
It's called Karen Rolton. I think you're right the first time. We haven't played there this year. We trained there with the stateside on the oval behind it, and what a magnificent facility.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah. The envy of every other club, and I guess one thing that it will do is hold up in the winter, given that nobody trains on it. I think it'll be a good deck every Saturday.
And the Sacra are there preparing it week in and week out and manicuring it.
Yeah, it'll be a beautiful place to play footy, and Old Iggy's very lucky.
Yeah, anywhere where they've got grade cricket or they're going to play state cricket there, they're going to manicure that all the way through winter.
Yeah.
So,
yep.
This week, there is Old Ignatians playing Golden Grove at Karen Rolton Oval.
Yeah, it'd be a good game. I think I'll go with Golden Grove to get two in a row.
Yeah. Arnhem Sadies Jets there at home, and they've got Foss Camden. Interesting game.
Yeah, this is another beauty. I'm actually going to go with Unley. Yeah.
Yeah, at home.
Yep.
It's that long, well, not so long, but narrow...
Skinny oval, skinny, yeah, that goes the other way, yep.
It's a bit weird, isn't it?
Yep.
A lot of these players would know each other at the Sacred Heart Middle School. Sacred Heart taking on Brighton.
Yeah, this is a local derby too, isn't it? And I think it was pretty close the first time. Might have been only a couple of points in it the first time they played.
Yeah, a lot of them went to Sacred Heart and Brighton High and all those things.
Yeah, and the first game was at Brighton, so it was the first time they played against each other for many years. This is at Sacred Heart Senior School or Middle School?
This is at the Middle School.
Middle School, which is a bit of a peculiar ground. Sacred Heart tend to play well there.
Very odd ground, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think Brighton are hitting their straps pretty well at the moment, so Brighton for me.
Obviously, your game is the last because there's no Salisbury North and St Peter's now.
Yep.
But you're taking on Gaze at Broadview Oval.
Yeah, it's another local derby, isn't it? Since they say that it doesn't matter where you are on the ladder when these two clubs meet, it's always pretty tight. So we took care of Gaze at first round, and I'm sure they'll be looking for some revenge. So
Gaze seem to have a lot of guys in that older category where they've got Rudetti, Aloka, Stevens, etc. They might have like Hinesy mid-27s, but then they've got a lot of kids with young Bioli and Lauder and etc. So they just don't have that experience, 24-25-year-olds.
Yeah, see, Lauder's been in the B grade for a while now.
Yeah.
And Bioli didn't play on the weekend. So
he spent a bit of time in the Goose as well.
Yeah. So I guess you're going to get some inconsistency with young players. That's just the nature
50,
of the
60 games before they start to... Yeah, a bit of consistency.
Yeah, oh, you're right. The top end, their experienced players are very good. Hines, Stevens, Rudetti. So yeah, we'll look forward to a good game.
Yeah, I suppose obviously Hines would be the bloke you'd be having to stop.
Yeah, we'll play three on Hines.
Yeah, so he would be just about everyone he plays, and no, you've got to match up with Hines. I think,
yeah, I'd play him in defence if I was Jars.
I don't think you'll see that somehow. Yeah, thank you very much for doing the weekly roundup.
No worries.